So you're going to stay by me. We're going to play a game here in just a second. First of all, tell me your name and where you are from.
I am Noah Kars from Morningstar in Jackson, Wisconsin. Represent.
I am Kelly Keenig and I'm from St. Paul,
England. Fantastic. Thanks for both coming up here. The game that we're going to play is a trivia game about Bowling Green State University. Okay? And the way it's going to work is I'll set up a question, and our special guest will read different choices. I'll read one of the choices as well. And then you guys will have to confer with each other and decide which one you think is correct. All right? So you should probably stand next to each other. Our special guest question announcers, you guys can come on up, are Pastor Sims. Give it up for Pastor Sims, who we saw yesterday in the morning. Thank you for being up here. Dr. Michael Brown, who we saw on our very first night here. He's our representative from BGSU. Give it up. And Pastor Dustin Bloomer, who fought Goliath earlier for us. So, like I said, I'll set up the question, and then they'll read the answers, A, B, C, D, and then you guys will guess which one you want. Question number one, when and why was Bowling Green State University established?
A, it was established in 1866 as a college for falconry.
B, it was established in 1910 as a teaching college.
C, it was established in 2018 as a location for the Wells International Youth Rally.
Or D, BGSU has always been and will always be. Isaac Izumba is a magic spell. B is correct. B is correct. Well done. Question number two, what are the school colors?
A, definitely orange.
B, yes I agree, orange is a big thing.
C, orange, and a secondary accent of brown.
Or D, I'm colorblind, I have no idea. C is correct, very well done, C is correct. And now, our next questions, our closing questions, all have to do with that fantastic and creepy cemetery that's in the center of this campus that you have walked past many times. All right. Number three. Which of the following is a real, and frankly a little bit overdramatic, paragraph from an article that was written about Oak Grove Cemetery, that cemetery in the middle of campus? Listen close.
A. It was a dark and stormy night. The rain fell in torrents, except at occasional intervals, when it was checked by a violent gust of wind which swept up the streets, rattling along the housetops, and fiercely agitating the scanty flame of the lamps that struggled against the darkness.
Well read. Thank you.
That's A.
I'm moved to tears.
How about B? While students rarely enter Oak Grove just to observe, the mere presence of it still induces spine-chilling sensations. Walking along the outside of Oak Grove's gate, along Mary Avenue, the atmosphere of the cemetery still lurks. The unseasonably mild weather has created a thick layer of fog descending on Bowling Green. Visibility decreases, and the innermost parts of Oak Grove Cemetery can be barely seen. The sound of the breeze echoes out in the cemetery, almost as if the deceased are calling out for a living company.
Almost as if the deceased are calling out for a living company. Bone chilling.
C. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. It was the epoch of belief. Epoch of belief. It was the epoch of incredulity. It was the season of light. It was the season of darkness. It It was the spring of hope. It was the winter of despair. We had everything before us. We had nothing before us. We were all going to wreck.
Sure.
We're all going to wreck the other way. In short, the period was so far like the present period that some of its noisiest authorities insisted on being received for good or for evil in the superlative degree of comparison only.
Give it up for Pastor Sims for reading that massive section from what book? You know? Channel 26. Very good. Or was it D? One fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish, black fish, blue fish, old fish, new fish. This one has a little star, this one has a little car. Say what a lot of fish there are.
B!
It was B. Yeah, B from a very short-lived blog in 2012. Very interesting little article. Number four. Which came first, Oak Grove Cemetery or BGSU? Letter A.
A. After establishing BGSU in 1910, the university's first president, Dr. Bowling Green, died of a tragic heart attack. He was buried in the place he lay, in the center of the campus, and the cemetery grew around him as a monument to his wisdom and his kindness. That was A. Here's B. Back in the early 1870s, Bowling Green was engaged in a political battle with Perrysburg, with each city fighting to be the county seat. During that time, having a rural cemetery was seen as a strong point of the development of the town, so in 1873, the city of Bowling Green paid $950 to John and Robert Eldridge for the 9.5 acres of land that Oak Grove Cemetery now sits on.
Oak Grove Cemetery is actually the largest work of sculpture art in the United States. Covering 13 acres, the cemetery is a metaphor for killing one's ignorance by pursuing higher education.
Or D. The cemetery was established in 2017 after the Youth Rally Committee decided they wanted to play a trivia game with questions about the cemetery. So I will accept it. B is the correct answer. Well done. Your fifth and final question. Who is buried in Oak Grove Cemetery?
A. Many of the graves contain people who were buried before the cemetery was founded. In April 1873, the city began drawing lines and lots to divide up the burial plots. The stones and bodies in Oak Grove were transported from the two graveyards near Bowling Green and placed in Oak Grove.
Choice B. Each and every grave contains one student who failed to study hard enough for one of the late Professor Snape's dark arts course finals.
Yes!
Or C. The graves are filled with the dashed hopes of every athletic opponent who has come onto campus, believing they could defeat the Falcons.
Thanks.
Only to find that Freddie and Frida and the rest of the BGSU sports program are not to be trifled with.
Or is it D? The cemetery is filled with all the participants in the last Wells Youth Rally that we had here at BGSU who lost their keys, and you thought $75 was a high price. Give it up, they won the game. Congratulations, guys. Give it up for our guest announcer folks for their excellent readings of very difficult paragraphs.